Welcome back to my channel and today's video. I hope you're doing well. Thank you for joining me today's video. I appreciate your support so much. And you guys, if you're new, welcome. This is Moon. I'm a perfume lover and reviewer, and here on my channel I talk about perfumes and beautiful scents. So please, if you're interested in my content, make sure to like, comment, and of course subscribe, as it really helps support my channel. And now without further ado, let's get started. So today's video, as you can see, it's my top 10 summer fragrances, you guys. And today's list, I have different types of summer fragrances. I have the musky clean ones, I have the floral ones, I also have the fresh fruity juicy ones. You know, I have everything, you guys. I have also some affordable ones and some luxurious niche options. So I hope you're gonna enjoy today's video, and I'm going to rank them from, I would say, least favorite to top favorite. But if you ask me, I love all of them so much. But if I have to rank them in a countdown, it's going to be in this order. So I'm gonna start with number, of course, Tennis Pot, and it's going to be a fragrance from Guerlain House, and it's from the Aqua Allegoria line. If you know this line, it should be very refreshing scents for summer, of course. They are not that strong, but they are very, very refreshing, actually. And the one that I'm going to talk about right now is it's called Flora Rosa. As you can see, you guys, the bottle looks very, very beautiful. I just love them so much. And the fragrance, you guys, again called Flora Rosa. So this is should be a rosy floral, of course, but you guys, this fragrance is a tart rose, a sour rose. That's why it's in number 10 spot for me, because I'm not a huge fan of sour fragrances that much. But you guys, I really enjoy to wear it during summer days. It really smells very refreshing. This fragrance has only 4 notes. It has red berries, and that's what the tartiness comes from the red berries. And here it doesn't smell sweet at all, it just smell tart. And also it has rose, of course, and has also some iris, and it has a base of musk. So as you can see, it doesn't have any sweet notes. It's just a very refreshing tart rose, and the dry down smells very, very clean from the musk. And here it really smells very clean. That's why I like it so much, because it really smells very refreshing, sparkly rose, you know, with that musk base. It really smells very, very beautiful, you guys. Also, this fragrance opens up smelling like something green. I think it comes from the flower. It's like you're smelling the actual flower, you know, with the green leaves or the stem of the flower. Very, very beautiful, you guys. But as I said, you have to appreciate tart fragrances or tart scents to appreciate this fragrance. And by the way, also the longevity is very, very good. That's why I recommend it. And in number 9 spot, I have a staple on any summer collection, and of course I'm talking about Light Blue Intense by Dolce & Gabbana. And as you can see, this is the intense version. I prefer the intense version over the original one, because first of all, this is last longer on my skin, and second, I feel like this version is a little bit more feminine than the first one, or than the original one. So that's why I prefer the intense version, you guys. And of course, even if you don't like citrusy fragrances, just like me, because I don't like citrusy fragrances, and actually this is the only prominent citrusy fragrance I have in my collection, and I love it so much. So even if you don't like those very citrusy fragrances, give it a chance, because in here really smells very beautiful and very well balanced with that green apple note, and also with that musk. It really balanced out the citrusy bergamot and lemon in this fragrance, and that's why, you guys, I love it so much. It smells very refreshing, very clean, especially right after shower, and of course during daytime and hot summer days. Yes, when you need something to make you feel better, make you feel clean and fresh, it really does the job. And I believe this fragrance, it should be a staple in on any summer collection, of course. And I think also it could work on a man. Yes, I would say this is a unisex fragrance, even though it's targeted to the woman. But in my opinion, this is could work as a unisex fragrance. But it's just really beautiful, you guys. And that's why I highly recommend it, of course. So this was Light Blue Intense by Dolce & Gabbana. And in number 8 spot, I have a very creamy fragrance, and actually it's kind of new release from Narciso Rodriguez House. And this fragrance, you guys, smells very creamy, smells very summery, smells like suntan lotions or sunscreens, you know, if you like those types of scents, especially of course during summer and during vacations, you know. And this fragrance is the new Narciso Ombre, of course. Very, very beautiful color, you guys. The bottle looks very, very beautiful and feminine. And you guys, as I said, this fragrance smells really creamy, just like, you know, sunscreens and suntan lotions. Is that creamy, you guys, from frangipani flower and also ylang-ylang flower, which together smelling that, you know, creamy and very, very smooth, you know. Yeah, this is smells very, very smooth from those yellow flowers, and of course also it has, I think, jasmine, which makes it even more creamy. And the base in here, you guys, smells very, very beautiful with that amber and cedar wood. This fragrance is not an amber prominent scent, even though it's called ombre, you guys, this smells so, so beautiful. So yes, for me, this is not an amber based scent. It's not you know, a very heavy amber scent. Actually, the amber in this fragrance just gives it a little bit sweetness in the background, and also it makes it smell a little bit salty, just like you're smelling the real amber, you know. But other than this, it's a very creamy, floral, you know, jasmine-y, very feminine scent, and really works great during this time of the year. Highly recommended, of course, if you are going to a vacation and you're looking for you know, tropical, creamy, very feminine and very floral scent. Highly recommended, of course. And also it has a good lasting power. This is last on my skin for so long, you guys, actually the whole day. Yes, I love the performance of this fragrance. I love this scent so much, you guys. And also, even though if you don't like musk fragrances that much, I highly recommend it still, because the musk in here doesn't smell animalic, doesn't smell so strong or anything. It just has a hint of the Narciso's signature musk, makes it unique, of course. Oh, you guys, I just forgot to tell you before I go to the next one, if you like Terracotta by Guerlain, you're gonna love Narciso Ombre so much, because both of them have the same style and same vibe. This is also, you know, ylang-ylang and also frangipani flower, but this one has coconut and tiara flower, which makes it even more you know, creamy and coconutty. But because this one is discontinued and I know it's very hard to find, that's why it's not in the list. But if you ask me, I love it more than the Narciso Ombre. But if you can find it, and if you're looking for those type of scents, definitely get it. If you can't find it, you can get Narciso Ombre instead. And this, I would say this one is a little bit sweeter also than the Narciso Ombre one, but I just absolutely love it, you guys. And I thought I have to mention it in this video if I'm talking about my top favorite summer fragrances. So this was Terracotta by Guerlain. And in number 7 spot, I have the newest fragrance from Giorgio Armani House, and it's a white floral based fragrance. And of course, you guys, I'm talking about My Way by Giorgio Armani. You guys, if you're looking for a white floral scent that gonna last you the entire day, definitely check this one out. This one has an incredible performance, you guys. Lasting power, I'm talking about 9-10 hours. Also, it projects very, very well. So really, the performance of this fragrance, just impressive. So when you first spray this fragrance, you guys, you're gonna get an orange blossom smelling. With that bergamot, it's gonna create something like orange juice. Yeah, it really smells like orange juice for me, especially when you first spray it. And then after a few minutes, you're gonna get that heavy dose of tuberose and jasmine, which is here. Smells very, very, I would say, realistic smelling of tuberose and jasmine. And then it has a base of vanilla, I think, and cedarwood, and also some musk, I believe. You guys, this is very beautiful scent. This is very sparkly, refreshing, still very unique white floral scent with hint of vanilla. If you're looking for a very clean, juicy, fruity white floral scent with an incredible performance, of course you need to check out My Way by Giorgio Armani. And in number 6 spot, I have a very beautiful, unique, and mature summer scent from Lalique House. And this fragrance, you guys, of course, is Lalique Soleil. I absolutely love this fragrance so much. And of course, also the bottle is everything about this beautiful, beautiful, artistic and creative bottle. Very, very classy and unique. I love this fragrance, you guys, because it's really smells very different. It has his own character. I haven't smelled any gourmand summer fragrance like this in my collection, so that's why it has a special place in my heart, because it really smells unique. This fragrance, you guys, has many, many notes. It has some spicy notes like cardamom, and also it has many sweet notes like caramel and praline. But if you ask me, it doesn't smell that sweet at all. It's just a very well blended scent, I would say. As I said, it has cardamom, it has of course orange and mandarin orange, which smells very fresh. It's like you're smelling a fresh or freshly squeezed orange, and you're drinking this orange, you know. Yeah, smells very sparkly, orangey. Oh my goodness, with that hint of cardamom. Really, really, you guys, this fragrance smells very unique. And also, what makes it very works during summer days or nights, as I said, it doesn't smell that sweet at all. The sweet note in here just gives it a hint of sweetness. It just makes it smelling very feminine and gourmand and delicious, of course. Yes, very beautiful, a little bit creamy also, because it has a milk note, which is gives it a lactonic vibe. And also with that jasmine flower in here, makes it even more creamy. And of course, it has also a base, a unique base of cedarwood and vanilla, and also some musk also, because you're gonna really smell something very musky and clean, and from that musk, and also a little bit woody in the base. So it's just a very beautiful and unique composition that could work easily during summer days or even nights. So that's why I recommend it, you guys. I know it's still expensive, but it really worth it, because the performance also is amazing. This lasts so long on my skin and also projects very, very well. So that's why this fragrance should be in today's list. So again, this was Lalique Soleil. And now, you guys, my top 5 summer fragrances. In number 5 spot is going to be a fragrance from Chanel House. And I think you have guessed it right because you know how much I love this fragrance from Chanel, especially during spring and summer. And this one, of course, is Chanel Chance Eau Tendre. You guys, this fragrance, the Chance Eau Tendre or the Chance Eau Fraîche, both of them are great during summer. But if you ask me, I prefer this one more. If you like me and you don't like very citrusy fragrances, just like Eau Fraîche, you know, the one that has a green juice. Yes, this one is amazing too from Chanel House, but of course this one is more of you know, lemon and bergamot and citrusy. If you don't like those type of scents like me, go for Eau Tendre. This one also smells very refreshing from the grapefruit note. The grapefruit note in here, you guys, smells very, very beautiful, very, very juicy. Oh my goodness, very juicy and very beautiful with some pink flowers, with some also iris, some iris flowers mixed very powdery with that musk base. This fragrance could work for any age, you know, from 20 years to 60 and 70, you know, everyone's gonna love it, you guys. I know Chanel fragrances is more of the mature age or mature taste, but really, Chance Eau Tendre could work for anyone. Even the young girls would love it so much, but in my opinion, this still has that uniqueness. You know, it doesn't smell like an average, you know, fruity floral scent or very girly scent at all. This still has that, you know, Chanel's signature scent, which is makes it unique. Of course, you know how much I love this fragrance. Amazing. Fruity, floral, powdery, clean, still very unique scent. Highly recommended, of course, from Chanel. And again, this is Chance Eau Tendre. And in number four spot, I have another fragrance from Guerlain House. You guys, I love Guerlain House so much, and I believe this house makes floral fragrances best thing ever, you know. So that's why I have another fragrance from this unique house, of course, and I'm talking about Champs-Élysées. If you're looking for a soapy floral scent, just go for this one. It's an affordable fragrance, of course, so that's why I have to mention it in this video. Because if you're looking for a very, very unique and mature, but still affordable fragrance, you know, floral and soapy fragrance, definitely check this one out. This one's gonna make you feel so clean, just like you stepped out of the shower, you know, but in a very unique and high-end and classy way. So as I said, it smells very soapy. It has some fruit notes, but I can't smell any fruit notes in this fragrance. I can't detect it because it's a very, very well-blended scent actually, but it has many floral notes, all types of florals, you know. It has mimosa, it has heliotrope, it has iris, it has some white florals, it also has some peony and roses. So it's like you're smelling a huge floral bouquet with that base of musk and cedarwood. Makes it mature, I would say. This is more of the mature age, but still very, very wearable and very easy to wear. I always find myself grab this fragrance when I don't know what to wear, you know, because it really very easy to wear, but still very unique and high class, clean and soapy scent. Of course, highly recommended to you guys, and performance also is very, very amazing. So this was Champs-Élysées Guerlain. And now in number three spot, I have a fragrance from Prada House. And if we're talking about the most beautiful, clean, and soapy, and gorgeous summer fragrances, I have to mention this one, you guys. And I also raved about it so much before because I absolutely adore it. And this fragrance, you guys, of course, is Prada La Femme. This fragrance to me, it screams femininity, screams uniqueness. And at the same time, it smells very likable, very pleasant, also crowd pleaser scent. I always get complimented when I wear this fragrance because it really smells very, very unique. Tuberose and jasmine scent was, it's a little bit spicy also, especially in the opening. and then it's gonna start to dry down to the most beautiful creamy, soapy and powdery white florals. It has also some iris, makes it even more powdery, and with that unique base of beeswax and vetiver and vanilla, just a very, very beautiful composition, you guys. And I need to spray with you right now because I absolutely adore it.
Yes, it smells very soapy, very clean, and very, very creamy also from those, you know, white florals. And it's just, oh my goodness, you guys, this smells very beautiful.
It also smells lotiony, you know, if you like the smell of, you know, lotions and body creams. It has that lotiony consistency to it. Amazing. And also it just has, my goodness, you guys, I just love it. I can't talk right now because I just want to smell it, you know. So yes, also it's not very sweet, you know, just has a hint of sweetness from that vanilla. Amazing fragrance, you guys. I really highly recommend it if you're looking for a clean, powdery, creamy, lotiony, slightly sweet, but very, very unique and elegant and classy at the
same
time.
And now, you guys, in number two spot and number one spot, I have some luxurious niche fragrances.
I also wanted to add something, you know, a little bit luxurious. If you're looking for a bougie, very niche quality and niche smelling fragrances, highly recommend these two fragrances to you guys. And in number two spot, it's actually a new addition to my collection. I've been wearing this fragrance lately so much. I absolutely adore it, you guys. And I'm talking about Killian Good Girl Gone Bad. First of all, Killian bottles are very, very beautiful and classy, of course. And again, this fragrance, you guys, is a white floral based fragrance. This fragrance opens up with the osmanthus flower, which here smells like apricot and peach. So if you like those tropical notes like apricots and peach, definitely you're gonna love this fragrance, you guys. I love those fruits so much in fragrances. That's why I love this fragrance. And then you're gonna start smelling in the middle those very beautiful and creamy white florals like jasmine, like tuberose again. But in here it doesn't smell sharp at all. It actually smells very, very smooth and very, very creamy actually. And as long as it sits in your skin, it's gonna get more sweeter and more woodier. So also, if you like woody fragrances, you're gonna love it so much because the cedarwood in here in the dry down smells very amazing, you guys. Smells absolutely beautiful and comforting smelling, you know, and unique at the same time. And also has a hint of sweetness from the amber note because it has some amber in the background, but it just gives it a little bit sweetness. They smells also a little bit mature, so this is not for young girls, because really the composition in here, for some reason, maybe the cedar wood that gives it that, you know, mature vibe to it. I also imagine when I wear it or when I smell it, I always imagine a, you know, a CEO vibes, you know, a businesswoman. This is her scent of the day, or even this is her signature scent during spring and summer. Is that mature? Is that unique? That, you know, ladylike fragrance. Highly recommend it, of course, you guys. And it also has a good longevity, amazing, amazing white floral, woody, fruity scent. It could work very, very beautifully during summer days, even at night also. So this was the number two spot, Good Girl Gone Bad by Killian. And now in number one spot, actually it's one of my top favorite summer fragrances. It's just a new addition to my collection. I've been wearing this fragrance, you guys, right now for 3 weeks non-stop, and I really can't get enough of it. And this fragrance, you guys, is from Roja, and this is Elixir Parfum. And of course, it's from the Essence de Parfum collection. So you guys, I received this beautiful fragrance from the brand, but you guys, I absolutely adore it. And of course, I'm gonna repurchase it when I finish it for myself again, because you guys, this smells very, very unique.
but still very refreshing and creamy and powdery scent. Amazing. This smells very, very amazing, guys, because it also smells very, very, very feminine. And if you know me, I love those very feminine fragrances. And to me, this fragrance screams femininity. It has many, many notes, many fruit notes, and also many floral notes, pink flowers, purple flowers like iris and heliotrope. It has also some peony, it has some mimosa, a very clean and unique base of musk and sandalwood, and also a hint of vanilla. So this fragrance, you guys, opens up smelling very fruity, I would say, peachy, raspberry, fruity. Smell those delicate flowers. The flowers in here are very well blended, I have to be honest. It's so hard to detect single notes, because the flowers in here are very, very well blended. All I can say that it really smells very smooth and very, very delicate and very feminine. And then in the dry down, you're gonna get that unique musk and cedarwood base with hint of vanilla also. Just a very, very beautiful and gorgeous composition, you guys. Really so refreshing, so amazing. It's gonna make you smell incredibly beautiful and clean and juicy and edible at the same time. That's why I highly recommend it, you guys. If you like those type of scents, of course give it a chance. Just absolutely stunning. So this again was Elixir Parfum by Rouge Parfum, and I really hope that you have enjoyed this summer list. Let me know in the comments if you have any favorite from this list. I would love to hear from you. And I also want to hear from you. What's your favorite summer fragrance in your collection? And again, you guys, thank you so much for watching. If you loved the video, please don't forget to give it a big like. And also, please don't forget to subscribe to my channel. I would absolutely love it if you did. And I really can't wait to see you in my next video.